Well, if I can say one thing about this album, it is that it didn't let me down. Hey, review family, keep it, I keep it. Time, my name is Jay Morris, a review guy, and I'm back again to bring you another video, and in this one, I'm going to be reviewing the new Papa Roach album entitled, Who Do You Trust? So, Papa Roach, they were formed in 1993. They're a hard rock and alternative metal band from California, and this is their 10th studio-length album, and if that is one thing that I can say is admirable, it is the fact that they've been able to make the same album 10 damn times. I will give credit where it's due. This album is a little bit more listenable than the major slew of albums that came out last year in the hard rock and alternative field that were complete and total dog crap. We're talking like Shinedown's album and Godsmack's album, Disturbed's album. What is with these washed up hard rock bands still releasing music even though they're not getting that high on the charts? The sound died in about 2007. Please leave it in the grave. One thing that I have to note right off the bat is that Jacoby Shaddix, whatever his last name is, I don't know how to pronounce it, the lead vocalist of Papa Roach, is a complete and total chameleon on this album. He changes up his voice so much to sound like other people that there are genuine times, and I'm not joking when I say this, that I had to go and look up if this specific song that I was listening to had a guest feature because he sounded so much like other vocalists in the game right now. And the bad thing is the vocalists that he's emulating are not even the best in the game right now. Yes, if I need to clarify, I'm basically saying you have an alternative metal vocalist that has been outdated since about 2004 doing vocals like people that are doing a style that is already very overdone already and washed out from now that was also dead in 2004 but are still making music but therefore are making even more washed down and watered down music. Therefore, Jacoby is trying to copy the people that are already washed down but then in turn is becoming more washed down and watered down himself. If you ask me, that's pretty advanced, but pretty easy to understand. Like, the ending starts off the track list, and let me just start off by saying, I wish this was the ending of the album. It's not good, I just wish I didn't have to listen to any more of this. He sounds like John Cooper from Skillet in the chorus. This was one of the times I literally had to go and look up and see if John Cooper featured on this track, because it sounds like he does a really good John Cooper impression. I gotta applaud that. This sounds like a Skillet song. If you told me this was a long-lost B-side from a Skillet album from like 2009 or 2010, I would probably believe you. This song does have some interesting riffs, but it really gets bogged down by the complete trope-filled and stereotype-filled angsty lyricism that was like in the new grunge movement in the 2000s, the post-grunge movement, and it really does not come off well in 2019. Renegade music is trying so hard to be epic and angsty, and it comes off sounding like 2000s Linkin Park. This has nothing to it. The guitars are super predictable and stereotypical for the genre and for this sound. There are no good interesting ideas. And for having 10 albums, it baffles me that they're still trying to do the same things over and over. Like, do they enjoy this? I find it hard to believe that they still enjoy this. Not the only one has the trope-filled acoustic guitar thing going for it in a hard rock album, but the thing that gets me about this track is it's super hypocritical. It has an interesting idea. It's basically talking about how life is hard, but that the bad things never last too long. I mean, there's the opening line, I was screwed up, I was angry at the world, I felt like a loser, and there's things like that, but the thing is, it's like, that's a good idea. That's motivational, that's nice. But it feels like a faux revolutionary type of outlook that feels so phony when you consider that every single other song on the album is you talking about how bad your life is. You can't talk about how, oh, bad things pass and you shouldn't dwell on it and it'll always get better and then completely make an entire album based around what you're detesting. You're not doing a very good job of disapproving it, that's all I'm saying. Who Do You Trust, the self-titled track, is the most eh track on the entire album. The chorus is boring, the verses are boring, the instrumentation is boring, the lyricism, like I said, is pretty hypocritical. It's a boring track from top to bottom. For the self-titled track, I was hoping it might be something interesting, but nope. Oh my god, the track Elevate. The track Elevate sounds like they're literally ripping off Imagine Dragons. And I didn't think this album could get any more stereotypical and boring than it already is, but it has the stupid whoa vocals. Literally, this song has whoa vocals with that stupid reverby, echoey, radio announcer type of effect on them. It's so stupid. Come Around is one of the more bearable songs. It's listenable. But when you're literally trying to say that an album is listenable as a comma, you know that you're grasping at straws of trying to find something good about an album. It's listenable. Do I want to listen to it? No, not really. But this has radio effect on it again. Okay, why do hard rock albums do this? Why do hard rock bands feel the need to completely always do this? I do like some of the lyrics where it's talking about, like, it's always darkest before it's light, but even that is such a cliche line. I've heard that in other tracks. It's a bearable track, but I applaud the band for making Feel Like Home sound like a 2005 emo rock song, from the trope-filled angsty lyrics about love and stuff to the complete and annoying whiny timbre on Jacoby's voice, which he does pretty well, I gotta say. He does that kind of,
my girlfriend left me and I'm sad. I can see the scars on your heart.
I mean, there's pop punk instrumentation all over this. I mean, if you like My Chemical Romance, check this song out. If you're sad about My Chem disbanding, then maybe check this out. But it's not a very good emo song. The track Problems is a little bit more bearable as well. This is probably my favorite track on the album. Jacoby does have a nice voice on this track. I gotta commend that. And the instrumentation is sweet. It's not overblown. It's not over the top. The only thing about this track is it seems differently mixed than the rest of the album. And that's the thing. The mix sucks on this album. There's no consistency in terms of the mix. It's all over the place with so many effects and so many different sounds, and they're not really sticking to one mix thing, to where from track to track, the vocals, the instrumentation is sounding different from the previous track and the track that comes after it in terms of the mastering of the album. But it's a pretty good track. It's a nice track. I do enjoy the sentiments on this track, and the lyrics are decent. I do like the instrumentation for the most part. Like I said, it's not too much, so I will give credit where it's due. This is a nice track. Top of the World is not a really good return to form compared to the last track. This is for the dreamers! The chorus sounds like a bad rendition of a Breaking Benjamin chorus off of their album Ember, but without the raw grittiness of Benjamin Burnley's voice. It gets watered down and it's boring, and it sounds like an Imagine Dragon chorus, but I'd probably prefer to listen to an Imagine Dragon chorus, and I never thought I would find myself saying that. I Suffer Well, one of the best tracks on the album. It's only a minute and 21 seconds, and it's a carryover from Top of the World. The energy on this track is insane. This is super punky. You have almost like a Beastie Boys filter on the vocals. It's super raw, throaty screams that I would not expect to hear from this type of album going by the previous tracks, but it did catch me off guard, and it was pretty good. I did enjoy this track quite a lot. It wasn't what I was expecting. It kind of blew me away, to be honest, compared to the other tracks, so good on them for that. Better Than Life ends out the track listing off in a decent way. I think that the vocals on this track are pretty good. The chorus is catchy and it's nice, albeit repetitive, and the verses do have this nice dark quality from the lyricism coming off as fairly genuine, as well as Jacoby's voice being very genuine, and the instrumentation being very dark, kind of down-tuned. It's not super in your face, it's not super, like, heavy or anything, and it doesn't really need to be. For the most part, this is kind of a stereotypical track, and it's not blowing me away by this album standards, but it's still ending off the album on a note that doesn't make me want to gouge my ears out of their sockets. This album is more listenable than some of the bad hard rock I heard last year, and there are a couple tracks that I do enjoy, and for the most part, this is better than a lot of those albums that I mentioned earlier, and I don't want to listen to this again. There would be some tracks that I might check out, but for the most part, this doesn't reach beyond the point of listenable, and the raw grittiness just isn't there. It's not genuine, it feels phoned in, it feels phony, and it's not really a good album from top to bottom whatsoever. It's filled with a lot of stereotypical lyrics. The performances are nothing you haven't heard on other Papa Roach albums. If you like Papa Roach, you'll probably like this album, and it's not a change at all. There's no experimentation for a 10th studio length album. They're pretty much Papa Roach 101, and I'm going to be giving this album a 4 out of 10, but ooh, God, is that a wrap? Please tell me that's a wrap, please. Hope everyone's staying warm. If you like the video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It helps me out a lot, and smash that notification bell to be notified of my future uploads. What did you think of this album? Have you heard it? Go ahead and post in the comment section below. I love open discussion, and I will talk to you guys next time. But until then, my name is Jay Morse, the Review Guy, and I'm signing off saying farewell.